Hello, friends. I experiment quite a bit with Home Assistant and related integrations and add-ons, which allows me to better understand how this system is structured, figure out the peculiarities of smart devices functioning, and so on. For this, I have several test servers and some devices that I can always use in my experiments. In this video, I will talk about backing up, restoring, and transferring a small Zigbee network between servers, managed by the ZHA integration, which is standard for Home Assistant. Before we start, as per tradition, I ask you to like this video. It will help others interested in smart home topics find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. At the beginning, I want to say a few words about the structure of Home Assistant. It consists of a software core responsible for the logic of the system's operation, automations, scripts, description of entities and objects. And to extend its capabilities and work with physical devices, there are integrations and add-ons. Integrations are, let's call them, the interfaces of Home Assistant itself, which are part of the system core. They allow it to receive various system data, for example, system monitor sensors, generate sound messages, update the weather forecast, interact with devices. One such integration is ZHA, Zigbee Home Automation, which works with Zigbee devices through a coordinator. Add-ons are essentially similar to integrations. They expand the capabilities of the Home Assistant core. However, they are not part of it. These are separate software modules organized in the form of containers. In some cases, they do not directly interact with Home Assistant, for example, Zigbee 2 MQTT works with the Mosquito Broker server, which is also an add-on. And Home Assistant works with the broker through the MQTT integration. Looking at the container structure, you can see that Home Assistant is just one of them, as is each of the installed add-ons. And to manage these containers, there is Supervisor, which allows installing, updating, and deleting them in one click. If it's not present, which also happens, all these operations will have to be performed manually. One of the very useful features of Supervisor is the creation of system backups. By the way, this process can be automated, and you can find a link to a tutorial on this topic in the description under the video. Here, the difference between add-ons and integrations is clear. Backup copies of add-ons can be created and restored individually, including extracting them from full backups. For example, you can restore only Zigbee 2 MQTT or Mosquito Broker without touching the rest of the system. But in the case of integrations, it is necessary to restore the entire system core, including all logic and automations. The goal of my experiment was to transfer the settings of a specific integration, ZHA, without changing the other parameters of the core. So, let's start. This is one of my test servers, which I used to create a tutorial on installing Supervised Home Assistant on Linux Debian 12. We need to go to the Settings menu and there select the Integrations section. Among others, there is Zigbee Home Automation. The integration can work with several coordinators, but each will have its own network. At the automation level, all devices will work with each other. Here I have created a small network based on a DIY USB Zigbee stick with firmware from SkyConnect. A link to the review is in the description. Along with it, there are 10 devices. 3 with router function, 7 from the Tuya Smart ecosystem, 2 from Acura. Before starting my testing, I checked the functionality of each of them. Events received by the system are visible in the log on the right. They can be used to create automations, but in this case, it's an indicator that the devices are connected and working properly. The integration makes backups automatically, but since I plan to transfer to another server, I will make a manual backup just in case. We press the configuration button. Here we choose to upload a backup. It is saved to disk as a .json file. It can be opened with any text editor. It contains data about the network, PAN ID, network keys, channel. Interestingly, in the child devices section, there are only 6 addresses, although, as you saw, 9 were connected. Now, I remove the integration of this coordinator from Home Assistant. I confirm and physically disconnect it from this server, in this case, a Raspberry Pi 4B. The type of installation is Supervised Home Assistant on Debian 12. In the integrations, there is no longer Zigbee Home Automation. The other test server is a SOYOM2 with a Celeron N3350 A link to its review can also be found in the description under the video. It has Home Assistant OS installed, so there is Supervisor here as well. Functionally, everything is identical. The integrations that are currently installed here. As you can see, there is no ZHA. I connect the stick to a free USB port. Unlike the Raspberry Pi 4B, where, in case of using an SSD, a small extension is needed, here, it can be connected directly. It was recognized as SkyConnect. After pressing the configuration button, in the next menu, I choose the first option to save the current network settings. That is, what is in the coordinator's memory, not using the backup file, we'll try that later. Besides the coordinator, the system immediately identified devices, routers. These are a socket and a relay with energy monitoring, as well as a bulb. A total of 4 devices, including the coordinator itself. However, after some time, the end devices started to be added. This process can be accelerated. If somehow they are acted upon, pressing buttons, short-circuiting contacts of the leak sensor and read switch. As a result, from the 9 connected devices, first 6 appeared, they are visible in this screenshot, and after some time, another sensor was added, a climate sensor. Interestingly, all from the Tuya Smart ecosystem. Acura, neither the button nor the switch, although they are the easiest to act upon, did not appear. And they did not just appear, but worked properly. All events, commands, everything was restored in full. To clarify, in this case, I did not use the backup file I created, just save the settings stored in the coordinator's memory. Now, I'll try to restore from the manually created backup. To do this, I remove the device from the integration. For the integrity of the experiment, I restart Home Assistant. I start again with adding the integration, find the coordinator by name, and press the configuration button. This time, I choose the second option, loading a manual backup. After this, a dialog for adding the file opens. We specify the path to it. We make sure we have selected the correct file and move to the next step. Remember, when I opened this file, there were only 6 addresses out of 9, and accordingly, only 6 devices were added, although almost immediately a 7th was added, along with the coordinator, 8, even though the original network consisted of 10. Again, the devices from Acura were not added. By the way, the temperature, humidity sensor, which in the previous test was connected last, this time, although it was detected, did not transmit data. I had to manually reconnect it and the devices from Acura. As it turned out later, the problem with the climate sensor was that it somehow managed to connect to one of my working networks. After reconnection, the data started transmitting normally. But the situation with Acura was unpleasantly surprising. The button and wireless switch of the E1 series, in neither the first nor the second case, were restored. It remains to check the restoration from an automatically created backup. Once again, I removed the device from the integration, and I reconnect it back to the original server, where it was before. Since after disconnecting the coordinator, I did not restart Home Assistant, it did not appear here automatically. Although it can be added manually, I want it to appear on its own, so I restart Home Assistant, and we start all over again. I search for SkyConnect and integrations, and press the configure button. On this server, besides the options previously considered, there is an option to restore from an automatically created backup. I choose it. Next, you need to select the backup date. I choose the most recent one, which was made before I disconnected the coordinator. To clarify, these backups are made automatically. I didn't take any action for this. In this case, all 9 previously connected devices appeared. The only thing that was not restored was the names I had given them after connecting. This is because they were stored in Home Assistant itself, not in the integration settings. All devices, including Acura, worked immediately after restoration. This suggests that the problem was not with the devices themselves, but in the manual backup creation mechanism, as the automatic backup restored everything. That's all. I hope this video taught you something new and interesting about how Home Assistant and ZHA work. Write your questions, thoughts, ideas in the comments under the video. I would appreciate your likes, they help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description under the video, you will find all the links to my reviews and tutorials that I mentioned, as well as to the Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.